السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My beloved brothers and sisters, I greet you all with the best of greetings. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. And we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by sending our salutations and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and upon his family, and upon his companions, and all of those who strive to be like him. Inshallah, on this brief Friday reminder, I wanted to just reflect upon some of the events that the MSA at George Mason has had this past week in honor of Charity Week. And for those of you who are not familiar with Charity Week is a week-long project that happens every year during the last week of October. And it's a focus on raising money for orphans and children in need all across the world. And alhamdulillah, the MSA here at George Mason has done an amazing job, has already exceeded their goals, has already surpassed their expectations in raising money for these orphans and needy children. And especially in this blessed month of Rabi'ul Awwal, the blessed month in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born, many people are starting to learn more about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are beginning to study the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than they had done before. And it's a great opportunity for us all to reflect upon the fact that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself was an orphan, someone who lost his father before he was even born, and someone who lost his mother when he was at a very young age. And there are numerous ahadith, we don't have the time to go into it, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in one narration, in one hadith, he said that I and the guardian of the orphan will be like this in Jannah. And he held his two fingers together like this, meaning that the person who takes care of the orphans, who looks after the orphans, who provides for the orphans, is so close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave this person such a high regard because he himself was an orphan. And we know that, you know, giving charity in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that holds so much value, is something that holds so much reward and ajr in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and something that we cannot even put on a scale. We cannot measure how many good deeds we get. We know from one narration, one hadith, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that a believer's charity is going to be their shade for them on the Day of Judgment. And in another hadith, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a person's charity is a means for their sins to be extinguished. Just as water gets rid of dirt, just as water cleans a person, the same way giving charity is a means of a person getting rid of their sins, of a person's sins being forgiven. And so this is a great opportunity, especially on this blessed day of Jum'ah, you know, giving charity for this cause of, you know, providing for the orphans. Feel free to go on the website charityweek.com and check out the various projects that Islamic Relief is helping, you know, so many different orphans and needy children across the world. And inshallah, especially on this blessed day of Jum'ah, don't let go of this opportunity. Don't let this day go past you without giving a dollar, without giving $5, without contributing in whatever way you can, inshallah ta'ala. And inshallah, it will be a means of success for you, and inshallah, it will be a means of you entering Jannah, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.